Does a company style of leadership make a difference on the company's performance on social media, particularly new media formats and platforms like TikTok, for example? To answer this question, I'm going to take you through two case studies that I know personally and I think are going to blow you away. But let's start with a question. How did Oreo win the 2013 Super Bowl with a single tweet? That single tweet got 525 million media impressions, by the way, which for 2013 is pretty impressive. And they didn't even have Tom Brady. How could that happen? But even worse, how can it be that major brands, you see an example of BMW, still struggle on new media formats like TikTok, despite their immense deep pockets? Now you of course say, what does he mean by struggle? We see no struggle there. Well, let me help you a bit. Can it maybe be that despite the orchestrated effort that BMW puts into their new TikTok presence, a small and local German supermarket overtook the entire show by getting double the likes on the comments just for being funny, contextually relevant, and super fast? Something's definitely wrong, and we have to find out what it is. Could it be that deep pockets, a lot of resources, and the classical top-down approach in marketing doesn't work anymore and doesn't bring the performance we were seeking in these new media formats? Let's take this a step further. Why doesn't the traditional marketing management leadership style work anymore, like we had for a lot of years? Think TV, think radio, think all traditional formats, also Facebook, by the way. Ivory tower style communication, top down. What is the difference in that buzz-filled, trendy, hype world of new media formats, like the TikTok platform we just mentioned? My hypothesis would be time, because time flies, and quite literally. The time to create content, the time to consume content, attention spans, and relevance have become shorter and shorter and shorter. Basically, companies do not have the time anymore for traditional approaches in marketing communication as they were used to. We'll look at plenty of examples, but I can pretty much assure that you can relate to some of the traditional approaches being top-down heavy. But before we continue, let me give you a very brief insight into the TikTok platform, just to be sure we're all on the same page and aligned with some basic knowledge. As you know, TikTok is a fairly new platform, being opened to the West, if you want, 2017, and just reached the 3 billion download mark. That makes it bigger than Facebook. As a point of reference, you know that the world has roughly 4.2 billion social media users. That's a pretty big number for a platform that came to be in 2017. It's a new format. It's that short video thing, right? Short clips, 15 seconds. The average clip's about 13 right now. So it's actually condensed media, condensed attention spans. It's an algorithmic-driven platform. It doesn't look at friends and families. It looks at your behavior. It looks at the user's behavior and what the user does. That makes it special. That makes the platform so different. And it's a bit aged-skewed, at least at the moment, which means more younger people, less older people. It's not Facebook. It's a cool new thing, as it always happens. And that, of course, brings a new brand challenge. And that challenge is to remain relevant in a creator-driven, fast, agile, low attention span centered, and particularly trend-setting platform. As I showed you, a lot of investment, but do we see the results, and why not? Well, let's look at leadership, which is the core of this leadership summit. And something that doesn't get mentioned quite often when we look at topics like marketing, communication, and surely not social media, because usually it's about resources, it's about the heavy investments, it's about having the bells and whistles, the social command centers, and all that sort of stuff. But maybe that's not just it, as I brought down in the hypothesis before. You see here the leadership model, or the model of leadership behavior, the continuum of leadership behavior, which I assume many of you will be probably much better familiar with than I am. On the very right, left-hand side, we see the autocratic style of leadership. The top-down, I give instructions and they have to be followed. On the right-hand side, we see, you know, to the most extreme, the laissez-faire, stuff happens and hopefully it's okay, right? And I argue that in the past and up to now, we have seen in marketing management quite often, actually, this autocratic top-down approach that starts not just in the function of marketing. It does start in the way budgets are assigned to the function of marketing, in a way goals and objectives are being set by top management and transcended down into the organization, into the place and scope that the function of marketing, under which, you know, you will find communication and, of course, social media, has in the organization. Does this still work? To give an example that, as I said before already, probably everybody knows, imagine a piece of media you want to bring to the world, or launch of a product, you want to support it with marketing communication. You work on that piece for weeks, for months. You involve different stakeholders. Who else do you involve? Legal, of course. What happens if you involve legal into any case? No offense to the lawyers amongst you, but things take long time. And we have to go through them, through them, through them. And what happens in this entire process? Nobody wants to be responsible. Nobody wants to pull the trigger or press the button, if you want, or tap on the screen, because you don't want to face the risks, right? You want to be sure that everything's okay, being approved by all these layers. And it has been tremendously great, as I said, for years in TV, on radio, to certain parts at least, and definitely in print. But it doesn't work anymore in this new feed media formats that require that speed, that agility, that reaction to events, like we've seen with the Oreo case that we refer to as a great marketing case study being called real-time marketing. Oreo reacting within minutes, I think it was like a 40-minute time span, or less, to this very particular happening at the Super Bowl and getting this attention. But let's look at what some, and particularly two organizations, do on the TikTok platform that I believe stand out and are an exemplary case for a new form of leadership spanning through the entire organization. And I'm pretty sure the organizations I've picked would be, or will be, organizations you wouldn't see coming in such a case. Spoiler alert, it's not going to be tech. The first organization we look at is a bank. And to make matters worse, a German bank. A Swiss bank will probably be the tip of the iceberg, but this is bad enough, trust me, right? So it's a German bank, which is a very traditional form of organization. It's a very traditional form of leadership. A lot of boundaries, a lot of regulations. But this particular bank is different. We talk about the Volksbank Mittelhessen, which is a local, I would say, medium-sized bank in Germany. And again, it's an example that I've used in a recent book of mine. What happened in this bank that I think makes it so worthy to speak about? Well, the management of this bank, C-level, figured some time ago, it doesn't really matter when that happened, that they want to give that TikTok platform a go. But they also realized they have two options. Go to an agency, spend a lot of money and see what happens. Or initiate a call to action to their employees, an internal job offer of who wants to kickstart their TikTok efforts. And guess what? Employees heard the call. Employees came to the call and said, hey, I would have an interest to do this. And it was young employees at that, which makes a lot of sense because we talk about a very young platform. So the bank empowered these employees with a phone, with the necessary hardware, no big investment or budget as such, and basically said, have a go. I interviewed these employees, and I found it incredibly interesting to hear, upon my question, What were the boundaries set by the bank? What were your approval processes to upload a TikTok for the bank? And they said, well, there was none. We work in the bank and we figured there's a natural boundary we cannot cross and we will not cross. And management trusted us to do the right thing. I've never come across an organization that gave so much empowerment and trust in their employees, let alone young employees, let alone into a new platform that most still didn't understand at the time this very journey began last year in 2020 for this very bank. I think that's been an example of not just empowering employees, but allowing experimentation and a very agile form of learning within the organization that I believe is worthy to mention. But another example is even better. When we think about new platforms, as I said before, we think about tech, we think about consumer electronics, and of course, information systems. Nobody thinks about industrials. And let me introduce you to Thiel Abeck SE, an industrial, a B2B player, who started again last year on the TikTok platform, which I believe amazing success. Of course, we don't see the hyped up numbers, but who needs them? Amazing success. And what happened there? We didn't have a top-down approach in this very case. We had a bottom-up approach. Well, you know, when I say bottom, I really don't mean the bottom of the organization. Starting from the head of PR saying, hey, we should really try this new platform. And let's assemble a team around me of young people because, and I quote him, I'm too old for this platform to meet the culture needed to be relevant on this TikTok thing. Amazing personality to speak to, by the way. So he rallied that team and they went to the board of the organization and said, hey, we have this idea. We want to start on this TikTok platform as a B2B, as industrial. And guess what? The CEO said, well, I know TikTok. Well, I didn't know the app quite so well, but he knew TikTok clips from the YouTube he was watching in the fitness club. You know, when you see the summary of the best TikToks and whatnot, that's what he knew. And he was like, give it a go. So that group of people at three, started around the head of PR. They brought the company to the platform and amazingly had great learning experiences. Again, felt very much empowered by the organization, but there's two more things that make this case so different from the bank. One, to me, is very authentic and transparent leadership. And let's give it in one example. They uploaded the clip, which was the best performing clip so far for the company. I think it breached 1 million views, which is absolutely great. The top management didn't like the clip. They didn't like it at all. They also didn't understand the clip because it was like a pun on Star Wars. But the top management didn't say, pull it back. They let it be because they said, hey, we gave the authority and they know what they're doing. It didn't go against any company policies. It was okay from that perspective. And another case that I think is interesting in this particular example, whenever you see a top manager in this company's TikToks, they wear the company's signature tie. Why? Because they want to be authentic. They cannot break their own rules, right? This is part of company culture, but it's also a leadership principle. What you want others to do, lead by example. And again, we see here, or as a slight difference, a very democratic decision-making level to be successful on this very platform. And I think that deserves a lot of applause in a B2B scenario. And to sum it up and stay within the time frame, I believe the two examples I've given you, although short and condensed, show that if you want to be successful in new media formats, you need to have a new style of marketing leadership